Okay, beautiful people, this is week 11, I think, right? I think this is week 11, and we are...
Interesting,
yeah, it is. We have 4 more weeks to go, something like that. And by the way, last week was the holiday, and I didn't make video for, you know, we didn't have class, and then I didn't know what to do. I thought this is holiday, and I didn't make a video. Today we're going to continue with what we were doing a couple of weeks ago. We were talking about pushing anatomy and the bone landmarks. We were talking about that. Today I'm going to talk about the muscle, the most important ones, very quickly. The one that you need to pay attention to. And then again, pushing the muscle means defining it better. Even if you don't see it very well, defining it for your audience. Today we have a beautiful male model, on male body the muscles are more defined, but doesn't matter, on female as well, pushing anatomy or pushing muscle means defining them, sometimes exaggerating in them to make a point. And then knowing them is very important, knowing the anatomy. Understanding anatomy and learning anatomy, it's an ongoing story, it's a never-ending story. You always learn more and you realize you have to learn even more. Then don't be discouraged if you don't know anything about anatomy. That's not the point. The point is that you try to learn it. You try, you know, every time you learn a little bit more and then keep going, and next time again you realize you need to learn more. This is my own story. I'm learning still anatomy, and I don't think anybody can say, I have enough of anatomy. And today I'm going to just emphasize on some basic important muscles that we are dealing with. Is that good? That's what we're going to do today. Let's start with neck and shoulder. First muscle there are two basic muscles that you have to pay attention to. One is we call it the M muscle, right? That I want to show that there's a muscle with two heads, right? The muscle starts from here and going one hip here, right? One hip there, you know, and creates a kind of M shape around the neck, right? And I drew it like that earlier before you came, right? It's kind of M shape. That's the muscle that you have to always pay attention to when you draw the neck. That's not the only one. Another one that creates the contour of the neck is the trapezius. That one head of trapezius that goes again. Trapezius attaches the skull here, shoulder blade here, and spine here is a muscle with 4 different heads. But one of the head go all the way here. Then in front of you, even in front of you, you can see that trapezius basically, these are two major muscles when you want to draw neck and shoulder, right? Going down, let's talk about the deltoid here as well, deltoid from front view. You always want to emphasize on deltoid. And deltoid, again, remind you that it's a very interesting muscle. It's connecting the clavicle and the shoulder blade and the arm bone, like that. And it's here, see that here, this is the deltoid, this is the deltoid. Again, in this drawing, this is the trapezius and the muscle of the neck are here, right? Another important muscle is the breast muscle, the muscle that goes like that and goes to the arm bone here, right? That's the muscle that we're talking about. That's the muscle that we're talking about. Important muscle always when you draw torso and shoulder and this part of the body. Then another, when it comes to the torso, one important muscle is the rectus here that attaches the rib cage to the pelvis, right? Important thing about this muscle is the kind of line that is creating on the body. You can talk about that muscle from many different points of view, but in my opinion, this kind of line that creates on the body is important and sort of is part of the design of the body. And there are four of them, and they get less curved when they go down. And the last one is almost lined up with the belly button. These central lines, these lines created by this muscle is very important to draw the torso and always try to see them, always try to emphasize on them and show your audience. And especially the pubic part area, this one also is important, that part. Of course, there are more muscles here. I mean, on this part of the body, the two-headed muscle is like that. This part here, on top of the pelvis, again, is very important. It shows you where the pelvis is, and you can see the this bone landmark underneath that muscle, and emphasizing on that muscle, we call it also love handle muscle. Is very important and the beautiful muscle to draw when you draw the torso. This is the most important muscles from front view, right? From back view, we have the trapezius again that we were talking about. And I don't know, in this drawing, I just did it for first year the other day. For example, again, this is a female, but I'm emphasizing on trapezius here, or I'm emphasizing on it here, as you see, and not much this part, unless you're in a special position that pops out, but otherwise you have to draw. I mean. You have to emphasize as much as you can the trapezius, and it goes like that, goes like that. Then this part is not very obvious, unless sometimes with shoulder blade, because it's engaged in shoulder blade, right? It goes all the way to the spine of shoulder blade, and then model does that, it pops out and you can see it, you can draw. Another important muscle is latissimus dorsi, that in this pose you can see it here, or in this pose you can see it here, and in for example you can see it here. Any drawing you do from back, you can see it here. It's over there. Any drawing you draw from the back, you're dealing with that. If you show us, and by the way, here you keep going. This is trapezius, right? This is trapezius. You can clearly see the different heads of trapezius. One going there, another one here going to the spine or shoulder blade, and the this part is going to spine. You can see that, right? And this is a latissimus dorsi that I was talking. There are other muscles around the shoulder blade and going there. I'm not talking about those at this point. these are important muscles, these two muscles, the trapezius and the latissimus dorsi from the back. Again, then you see the flank pad from behind here, and also the muscles of the I call it the small bone and the big bone, small bone and the big bone, right? They're the butterfly muscles that we have been talking about, and those are important, and you have to emphasize them. Later when you draw, it's going to be new, and you can see it better. This is about the back muscle that I want to put emphasis on. Let's go to legs. Legs, I've told you this many times, that the movement in the leg, and how the curves are working, is the most important thing in drawing the leg. You know, again, one movement going that way, this is the knee area, this is the lower part, and this is the foot, right? And you can build up the leg easily based on that. And this is all based on anatomy, right? And group of muscle here, group of muscle here, group of muscle here, group of muscle here, group of muscle here. And they have an interesting relationship as well, as you see the direction. And they all going sort of that way, except for the ankle joint that we talked about it in last class when we were talking about bone landmark. You have to emphasize all these muscles in a way that you push the movement of the leg. I mean the movement that is in the anatomy of the leg. I think pushing anatomy is important for any part of the body, but especially for the leg, and you have to be aware of. Right? What about the arm? By the way, before going to the arm, I thought, showing you that doesn't matter, female or male, you emphasize, you see, I talked about the shoulder before here. Here I'm trying to emphasize on latissimus dorsi, but here, small bone, big bone, I'm emphasizing, look, the leg. I am doing exactly what I'm suggesting you pushing the anatomy and the part of the movement that you see on the body. What about the arm? The arm, I have told you that when you draw the arm, pay attention to the fact that maybe something better. The fact that the arm's got four different parts. This is deltoid. This is the bicep, tricep, and this is the muscle that goes for the lower part. And you have the rest here, yeah? And then the hand going there. This part is going something like that. This part is going something like that. And this part is going something like that. And the rest is going something like that. Four different parts. If I show it on my own body, the deltoid is going that way, bicep, tricep going that way, the lower part of the muscle going that way, and the rest again going that way. Rest and I told you this is box number one, box number two, box number three, box number four. One and three are this, in a normal position like that. Same direction, box number two and four, same direction. These boxes are based on the muscle and muscle structure. And always when you draw the arm, try to emphasize on those and try to make it more obvious. For example, in this drawing that again I did, I'm exactly doing the same thing. Though my model is very skinny, not so much muscle, but I am trying to show to my audience that this is a deltoid. This is basically box number one that I'm doing. This is the bicep, tricep. I'm doing the box number two. Box number three is here, and box number four is the rest. Hand is a different story. You're not talking about that, but just the arm. Again, I'm following that and I'm trying to push those parts that again is based on a muscle. Pay attention, in box number three, when you're talking about this part of the body, the muscle, one side of these are two groups of muscle, but one starts way higher than the other one. As you see, that's very high and that's very low. Even in this pose, in this, which is kind of foreshortening I'm drawing, but again, I'm thinking of box number one, number two, number three, and number four is the rest. It's very helpful for drawing the arm, and of course, you have to push and emphasize. This is a very short review of the most important muscle that we have to pay attention to. Again, there are more, anatomy is a lot more than what I just tried to quickly talk about. But what I told you are very basic elements of anatomy that you have to pay attention to. And I want you to emphasize on them when you draw and push them as much as you can. Any questions so far? No? Okay, then let's try this and let's see how it goes. And you have a beautiful model today with lots of muscles, and try to see how it works. Okay? Then maybe 5 minute pauses. Yeah. Thank you. What do you think? Do you want to say anything about what we did? Pushing the muscles a little bit. No? And the last week we were pushing the bone landmarks, and this week muscles, and now in this hour combine them, all of them, and try to push the whole pose based on anatomy. I mean, that doesn't mean that you don't push other aspects. For example, you push the weight at the same time, or you know, and pushing is the thing that we are doing, and hopefully this pushing anatomy also will help. Okay, then let's do some more 5 minutes. Thank you.